Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Rising VLSI. In the video series of TCL TKS scripting, today I am going to use the loop statement to implement the logic gate functionality. So we have different logic gate like NAND, NOT, AND, OR, NAND, NOR, XOR and XNOR. So we may achieve this type of functionality with the help of TCL language, where input will be provided with this for loop statement. Motivation behind this video is this for loop do provide as the tabular result. So if I'm going to take this complete copy the complete program of this for loop and paste into a console window, it is going to provide just the tabular result. So this is a for loop from 0 to 2 increment and display the each value. Now this we can modify this tabular result to into a logic gate truth table formality. Okay, so now what I'm going to do here, first of all let me clear this console and I prefer to write the program into notepad. So in this case for each logic gate I'm going to use the procedure. So we will call each logic gate as a procedure and input will be provided with the help of for loop. So now let me start with, first of all I'm going to write procedure for NOT gate. So now this procedure required a input A and it return a single value. So for the more detail about the procedure, follow my earlier video based on the procedure. So it is going to return a single value with EXPR operator. I'm going to take the negate operator dollar A. Close the braces and command is. So this procedure is going to provide a single NOT operator. Now from the main body, I'm going to write a program for, first of all, I'm going to write puts. You can take some space, backslash T. NOT gate in the square font I have written here. Now I'm going to modify again puts statement. In this puts statement I'm going to modify the tabular column. First column will be the input, okay. Backslash T to make the space. Second column for the output. Now from the programming part, for I'm going to take the set I 0 initial value, dollar I less than 2 because we have the binary combination, so we can have only two value, either 0 or 1. Now increment I. Now in this case we have to display only one thing, puts. First I want to display here the input. Input is dollar I. Now backslash T after the space, we need to implement here the output. Now output is going to display here the this output to be returned from the procedure. So here I am going to call NOT. I am going to call here the NOT gate that will return here the that is going to provide here the result of the operator. So backslash T, let me remove the space. I'm going to give that also NOT. From the same name it is going to call the value and it do required a operator, variable. Afterwards this is the only program we need to write. So puts, it is the input column, NOT output for the procedure, it will return the output column. I'm going to save this program over the desktop. Suppose I'm going to give here the gate.tcl, save it. Now from the console window, if I'm going to source it, go for the desktop, gate. Now it is going to provide invalid command. So let me remove this where we have. So now look into the procedure. So I have taken here the open square braces. So again, go source, save it and source the file. Now what is the output we have got? NOT gate. As in the which structure we have written input column, output column. So in the missing, okay. So again, provide here this one. Now source it, gate. Now it is going to provide here the complete NOT gate, input, output. The same program can be modified to have, suppose if I want to display here the along with NOT, if you want AND gate or OR gate, simply what I'm going to do, we need to append the procedure. Suppose if I append A and B, because AND gate require two operator, it is going to return the value. It is going to return the expression in the EXPR $A. I need to use the AND operator $B, close the braces. Now in the put statement, so this will be helpful for us. I'm going to copy it and I'm going to provide the result. So now here backslash T, here I'm going to write the AND gate. Here since we have the two inputs, so again edit it, backslash T, input 2, backslash T output. We will get here three column, input 1, input 2, input 3. Now for loop, since we have the for loop, so I need to take one another for loop in between the to have the two different input. So for I, $i less than 2 increment, I am going to take the another variable, set j, $j less than 2 increment j. So we can have total combination 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Similarly, in the put statement, this put statement, I need to reframe the back $i, $i for the input 1, $j, that will be the input 2, I need to take backslash t so that we can have similar alignment, backslash t, and here I need to call the AND functionality or AND procedure. The variable to be passed here, the $i and $j. Again, I'm going to save it. I'm going to save it with the same name, gate.tcl. Now in the console window, if I'm going to source the same file, now it is going to provide NOT gate, AND gate, input 1, input 2, output, missing close braces, where I have got this issue. Yeah, because I have taken the two times I have taken the for loop, so I need to take one more statement as a for loop. So again, I'm going to save it. Now in the console, clear the earlier value. Now what I'm going to see here, NOT gate, it is going to provide a result, tabular result of the NOT gate. Similarly, going to provide tabular result for the AND gate. So in the same way, if I'm going to append the OR gate functionality, we will get here the OR gate truth table. What to do here, simply copy this value. Procedure, I'm going to copy it. I'm going to edit the name OR. Now here I am going to modify the operator of OR gate. Now here puts in the input side, we have to, we since our truth table of AND gate and OR gate is contains two input, one output, here I need to call here the procedure for OR. So it is a case sensitive language, so take care about it. Again, save it. Now in the console window, if I'm going to clear the console and source the same file, I will get here the output of NOT gate, AND gate and OR gate, and we can verify the truth table. It is similar to as our expectation. Now we need to take care about the some complex gates. Suppose when I'm going to implement NAND, NOR, XOR, XNOR, in those cases, since NAND gate, if I'm going to focus, NAND gate is a combination of AND gate followed by NOT gate. So we need to take the club. We need to club the two different gate procedure together. Very first, from the input, I'm going to take the, from the main program, I'm going to suppose if I want to implement NAND gate. Here, input will remain same, two input, and it is going to call a gate procedure of NAND. But here we need to club a different new procedure. This procedure going to call NAND. Here it requires two input A and B, and it is going to call the it will call the another gate or procedure NOT, and it is going to this NOT procedure will call a procedure for AND. So here I'm going to provide $A, then AND, $A, $B. Okay. So this is a method, how can we write for complex gate. Like in the complex gate, first of all, input A and J will pass to the AND gate, provide a single value result, pass to the NOT procedure. Again, it is going to provide a result for NOT. Again, save this file. Now in the console, clear the earlier. So now this is here we have I have written here the NAND gate. So now it is going to source it, source in the copy. Now what we have seen here, I'm going to get the NAND and also NAND gate is going to append. Now we can verify the functionality for NAND. Now what is the modification I have done? NAND gate is a I have taken the combination or merging the two different procedure to make a single procedure for NAND. On the same way we can modify for the NOR gate. So take the procedure for NOR. Now open the input AB. Here I need the NOT gate followed by OR gate. So very first I will call here the one procedure for NOT, which is required the output from OR procedure. So $A or $B. So these are the two input. There are two input for the OR A and B, and it is going to provide return back. It will going to provide return result from the NOT gate. Finally, we have the NOR. But in the input, I'm going to copy the again program here. So we have the one architecture wise, the truth table remains same. We have two input, one output. So only I'm need to call here the change the name of the procedure. Again, save this file, clear the console. Sorry, I have closed it. Let me open it again. So this. So let me zoom it somewhat. Okay, now it's good. Okay, now from the file again, I am going to source the same file gate. So what we have seen now, the my result going to append NOR gate, which is we can verify the functionality again. This is opposite of the OR gate. So in this way, the TCL provides us the feature to mix or to nesting of the procedure. To have the and it can we can make here the complex functionality. The larger last one, that is the XOR and XNOR gate. So XOR XNOR gate, which required the nesting of three procedure, NOT and OR. So we required these three procedure must be available to us. Afterwards, here I'm going to write one procedure for procedure for XOR. Here input I required AB. Now what is the equation for XOR? We know as we know the equation for XOR is A bar B plus A B bar. So we need to write first A bar B plus A B bar. So XOR gate, as we know the equation for XOR is A bar B plus A B bar. Very first we need to implement, I am going to call here the NOT of $A, and this function not this is one command we need to call $A, and this command must be governed by another command AND. So AND $A and $B. So this will implement A bar B. Another command I required here, the again AND of A and NOT of $B. Here also I need to write $. So this this command going to implement A bar B. From this command I am going to implement A B bar. Now this complete is going to call inside another OR operator, because this is a single statement I need to write to implement the XOR functionality. On the same hand, I'm going to write here the procedure for XNOR. We know the procedure for XNOR equation say here the AB and plus A bar B bar. So first of all, take the two operator AB. Now I'm going to write first AND. First of all, start with here like AND. What are the function we need to write first? And $A, $B. It will implement very simple AB. Another function I need to call here the AND of for NOT of $A. Close the command. Close and we call another procedure NOT for $B. So this command going to implement dollar $AAB, this command going to implement dollar $B, and this complete going to call another of procedure for OR. So it will have the complete equation of XOR gate and XNOR gate. Now from the input I am going to copy the same pattern that will be helpful for implementing the XOR and XNOR. So I'm going to simply here I need to call here only to change the name of procedure for XOR. Here I'm going to change the name of procedure for XNOR. Okay, simply append the value X. Now save it. Now from the console, if I'm going to clear the earlier result, now source it. Now gate. So now what we have here, I can showcase here the result. First of all, I have got result of NOT, then AND, OR, NAND. Here I have got NOR. And the bottom, I can have the appended result, XOR gate. So it will implement 0, 1. For these two, for different input, we have the high output. And for XNOR gate, same input, we have the high output. So this is the one of the feature which I have verified from TCL language. So we can verify the functionality, or we can implement different logic gate with TCL language. So I hope you must have enjoyed this video series. So in the next video, I will describe how can we implement digital logic design like adder or subtractor with the help of design logic gate in TCL language. So thank you for watching this video.